Welcome to the Urban Retreat. So during the week we're going to be teaching you a meditation practice known as the Metta Bhavana. It's a traditional Buddhist practice, and Metta Bhavana translates to something like the cultivation or the development of loving kindness. So it's a meditation that is all about learning or cultivating friendliness, kindness towards oneself and others. And yeah, if you really get into the practice, there's four benefits that it can bring. So firstly, it can help you just be more aware of your own emotions, your own emotional reactions to other people. It can help you just be more emotionally alive and aware in that kind of way. Secondly, I think it can help you become more robust and more confident and less blown around by things that happen day to day, moment by moment. And thirdly, it can also help you to be more kind and less inclined to anger or irritation, or at least less swept away by those kind of negative emotions. You can learn to deal with those better. And the fourth thing is that it can also help to be more aware of suffering in the world and to stay aware of that suffering without being overwhelmed by it, and you know, maybe even able to respond creatively and helpfully to any suffering or difficulty that one sees around oneself. So in a way, that's where the practice can lead if we really practice it over time. And I'm just going to start by explaining four principles by which the practice works. And then after that, I'll explain how to do the practice, how to actually do it when you're sitting on your meditation cushion or in your chair. So the four principles were, firstly, when we meditate, we're just trying to be more aware, to get more deeply in touch with ourselves. And in this practice, particularly, to be more aware of our emotional attitudes, responses, the kind of underlying emotional tone to our experience. Yeah? And we do that by just sitting quietly and allowing that awareness to emerge over time. It takes time and sensitivity. And we just watch our body and experience any sensations in the body. We watch our heart and just notice how we're feeling in our heart, how we're feeling emotionally. And we watch our mind and the kind of thoughts and stories that are running through our mind. And yeah, we just note all that and experience all that and ask what that tells us about the underlying emotional tone to our experience. What's going on with us at that moment? And then the second principle by which the practice works is, in a way, to step back from that, not to over-identify with whatever's happening at any given time. Yeah? So whatever's happening is just what's happening right now. It's not you in any kind of fixed or ultimate sense. You don't have to over-identify with the stories that are running through your mind, for example. You don't have to believe everything you think, you could say. And then thirdly, if we're able to do that, if we're able to become more aware, able to step back a little bit in that way, then we create a bit of space and we create the opportunity for making more choices about the kind of intentions, the kind of wishes, the kind of emotions that we want to cultivate. So that's the third principle, is trying to cultivate positive emotions or positive intentions. Just having well-wishing towards ourselves and other people. And then the last kind of underlying principle is that we expand that out to include as many people as possible. So you'll see when we do the practice that we start with ourselves and then a good friend. And then through the five stages of the practice, we just carry on expanding out to include more and more people, trying to broaden our sphere of concern. Yeah. So that's how the practice works in theory, as it were. And now I'm going to explain how we actually do it in practice. So first of all, if you've not meditated before, you need to be comfortable when you're meditating. You need a good meditation posture. So elsewhere on the website, you'll find some resources for suggesting and teaching you how to sit comfortably for meditation if you've not done that before. And then you just sit quietly and settle into your posture and relax your body and just first of all, start with that awareness of whatever's going on right now. So just experiencing your body, experiencing the heart, and watching the kind of thoughts and narratives in the mind, the stories that might be running through your head. So just starting by trying to get more deeply in touch with whatever's happening at that given moment. Once we're a bit connected with that, we move into the first stage of the practice, which is cultivating metta, or loving kindness, towards ourselves. So the practice actually starts with ourselves, because if we don't feel good about ourselves, if we don't have a kind of concern and basic well-wishing towards ourselves, it's very hard to expand out to other people. So that's the first stage, just trying to have a healthy sense of ourselves, a wish to be happy, a wish to live a meaningful, creative human life, as it were. Then in the second stage, we bring to mind a good friend, so someone that we usually get on well with. And when we're new to the practice, it's best to choose someone that you're not sexually attracted to, and also someone that you don't have like parental feelings towards or filial feelings towards. Yeah. And the reason for that is we're just trying to, in a way, choose someone that's a bit straightforward, and our feelings for them aren't going to be, for example, feelings of sexual attraction or other feelings that we might mistake for metta, but which aren't actually quite the same thing. Yeah. So just choose a friend that kind of fills those kind of categories. In time, it's really important that we feel able to put everyone into the practice. So that little bit of advice is just for when you're starting off in the practice, just to give you a sense of what metta is in a kind of simple, straightforward kind of way. Anyway, we think of a good friend and we just bear them in mind. We just hold them in our awareness in the meditation and we wish them well. Maybe we think of their good qualities, what we appreciate about them. Perhaps we think of what's going on in their life and we just want them to be happy and fulfilled and live a healthy human life, as it were. That's the second stage of the practice. And then for today, we're going to keep things simple. So we're going to do the final stage, and tomorrow we'll do all five stages. But for today, we're just going to go straight to the final stage. And in this stage, we think of ourselves and our good friend together, first of all, and then we gradually expand out to include more and more people. So you might think of other people in your house or wherever it is you're living. You might think of people in the street, in the town, in the region. You just try and bring more and more people to mind in whatever way works for you, and have that attitude of warmth, awareness, considering them, considering their lives, wishing them well, wishing that they be happy and fulfilled, and so on. So those are the stages of the meditation that we're going to do today. And I've just got one more suggestion for how we approach that. And it's a traditional way of doing the meditation, which is to quietly say to yourself some words or phrases. So for example, in the first stage of the meditation, cultivating metta towards yourself, you might just quietly say something like, may I be well, may I be happy, may I be free from suffering. So just very quietly and gently and slowly, you drop some words and phrases, almost like dropping them into your heart and just noticing if it kind of sparks anything off, if it kind of helps a sense of loving kindness to emerge more fully. Yeah. So elsewhere on the site, you'll find a 30-minute led through meditation. So my suggestion is that you give that a try now or at some point during the day. And tomorrow we'll teach you all five stages of the practice. We'll do the whole practice. But for today, there's a 30-minute led meditation. And there's also, each day, we're going to have what's called a daily practice suggestion. And these are all going to be from Subhadramati. And she's just written a book called Not About Being Good. And the reflections and suggestions are all taken from her new book. And they're basically about practicing loving kindness off the meditation cushion. So they're basically reflections or suggestions for how you can bring this practice of metta or loving kindness alive as you're going about your day. So you'll find that on the site as well, and you might like to give that a try. And last thing to mention is do post up comments and questions, and there is a team of us who be responding to those. And yeah, just be great to hear how you're getting on. See you tomorrow.